Joan Brock has been a remarkable mom and inspiration to many.
She makes the best of everything.
She's very easy to be around.
Joan's pretty amazing.
At the age of 32, Joan suddenly lost her sight from a rare eye disease while working at a school for blind children.
It took my color and my depth perception, so I have no central vision at all.
I remember being 3 and laying in the hospital bed with my mom when she lost her sight.
Objects and things that we describe to her are more, she has a grasp of what they are.
If I step outside, I can pretty much see the outline of maybe a picnic table or whatever the case may be, and know exactly where it is and walk right to it. But in the light of day, everything's pretty much gone.
If you didn't know any different, you wouldn't even know that she's blind. I mean, she moves around the house, just like any sighted person.
It doesn't look hard. It doesn't look like a challenge. She makes it what it is. She goes that life with the tools that she has.
You just kind of put one foot in front of the other and get the work done that you have to do as a mother.
5 years later, she tragically lost her husband to cancer.
We were going to beat it. You know, we thought, you know, the vision loss was going to be the big thing in our life. Little did we really understand. That's when I really had to deal with my blindness, because I now had to step up to the plate. I mean, Joy became my eyes at 3.
She was left to raise her young daughter as a blind, single parent.
She lost her dad at 8, and I was bound and determined to find some way that, you know, we're going to find a positive way to lead our lives somehow.
You know, at 7, I was paying bills with my mom. I'd put her finger where the line is, and she would sign, and I'd package them up so the right thing was in the little window. And, you know, those are all things that, you know, we take for granted, but you have to make sure the right address is sticking out that little window.
And despite these obstacles, Joan maintained a positive outlook on life and transformed her struggles into inspirational lessons for her daughter and for others. A published author and inspirational speaker, her book, More Than Meets the Eye, was turned into a Lifetime television movie.
But I might need your help, so I don't put sugar on the chicken instead of salt.
Or pepper in the oatmeal instead of cinnamon.
Or ketchup on your pancakes instead of syrup.
Ew!
Years later, Joan found love again with her husband, Jim. The 3 of them, Joan, Joy, and Jim, built a happy life together in Tucson.
I knew what I was looking for, never could find it, and finally found Joan. And yeah, it didn't take long. I knew right away.
We were 40 when we got married. I think that's funny that he got married at 40 for the first time, married a blind girl with a daughter. You know, I just kind of threw him right into the action right away. You know?
Both me and my mom like to laugh, and he certainly brings laughter to the house.
Well, outside of the several shooting incidents, it's been an ideal marriage.
Joan's story is one of a life well lived.
I think true vision comes from the heart.
Moments, I'd like to take you on a journey through my life story, and my hope is that you'll take your life story and plug it into mine, both personally and professionally.
Despite the many obstacles she has faced, she moved forward positively and productively, inspiring everyone she has met along the way.
Everything has been so attractive, which has brought so many people like into her life that love her.
They're both great around people, and you know, I think Joy got a lot of that from her mom.
She's a remarkable woman.
You just never know what people have gone through, and you have to find that way in which you're going to balance your life and get up and on with it as best you can. It's just, we can all work together. I mean, everybody. Hey,